Morning students, welcome back to Shahada Math channel. This is the continuation video of the Eamcet coaching classes complex numbers video number 5, and this is the last video of the complex numbers topic. Okay, and the students who will follow these videos will definitely attempt so many questions in the coming Eamcet examination. So all of you practice these questions, make the notes and see all the models in this video. Okay, let us start the class. The first one, imaginary part of the z minus I by 2 I is equal to 0, then what is the locus of the z? So here this condition is given. What is the given condition? Imaginary part of the z minus I by 2 I is equal to 0. So first I substitute the z value in this condition. What is the value of the z? X plus IV. That is imaginary part of the x plus I by minus I by 2 I is equal to 0. First to take the simplification of this number, so this is equals to x plus I of 5 minus 1 by 2 I. Okay, now I multiplies this expression by the value, I applies the value I by to this one like that, which implies imaginary part of, now multiplying the values here, x into I x I, I square is equal to minus 1, minus of 5 minus 1 by 2 I square minus 2 is equal to 0. That is imaginary part of, the imaginary part is x by minus 2, minus of 5 minus 1 by minus 2, this is the real part, is equal to 0. So imaginary part of this complex number is equal to 0, that is the given condition. What is the imaginary part? Here we have x by minus 2. X by minus 2 is equal to 0 means the answer is x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0, that is nothing but the y axis. That's all, that is the answer. Okay, see the next problem. If z plus 2 plus 3 I, if modulus of z plus 2 plus 3 I is equal to 5, then what is the locus of the z? So this condition is given, mod z plus 2 plus 3 I is equals to 5. So first I substitute that z is equals to x plus I by in this condition, that is x plus I by plus 2 plus 3 I is equals to 5. Okay, which implies modulus, so first writing the real part and then imaginary part, x plus 2 plus I of 5 plus 3 is equals to 5. Now finding the modulus value, square root of real part whole square plus imaginary part whole square, that is x plus 2 whole square plus 5 plus 3 whole square is equals to 5. Now squaring on both sides, then we get that x plus 2 whole square plus 5 plus 3 whole square is equal to 5 square. Okay, what is this? This is nothing but the equation of the circle, center is equals to minus 2 minus 3 and radius is equal to 5. Okay, this in the form of the x minus h whole square plus 5 minus q whole square is equal to r square, where h is equals to minus 2 and k is equal to minus 3. Therefore the answer is this is a circle with center is equals to minus 2 minus 3 and radius is equal to 5. Now this is the next one. If arc of z minus 1 by z plus 1 is equal to pi root, then what is the locus of the z? Already we know that one formula. The equation arc of z minus z1 by z minus z2 is equals to pi by 2 represents a circle. This equation is nothing but the equation of the circle, represents a circle. Z1 comma z2 are the endpoints of the diameter. So here z1 comma z2 are ends of the diameter, end points of the diameter. So this equation represents the circle. Okay. So what is given here? One equation is given. This equation is nothing but arc of z minus 1 by z plus 1. So when we compare this equation with the above equation, just take the comparison of these two, then what is z1 value? Z1 is equal to 1 comma 0. And what is z2 value? Z2 is equals to minus 1 comma 0. Okay, so already we know that clearly this is the circle, this equation represents the circle. As that is, answer is the either first option or the second option. Now we want the radius value. First I am finding the radius value. Radius r is equals to, so these are the endpoints of the diameter, means the distance, the length of the diameter is nothing but the 2r, that is 2r is equal to distance between these two, that is equals to 2. Then the value of the r is equals to 1. Okay, just find the distance between these two, that is equals to 2 here. Then r is equals to 1. So means here the given equation represents the circle, the radius is equals to 1. Here these two are the endpoints of the diameter, means the distance between the two points is equal to 2r. Then r is equals to 1. So this is the circle with radius is equals to 1. If P represents z is equal to x plus IV in the arc of plane, mod z minus 1 whole square plus mod z plus 1 whole square is equal to 4, then the locus of the P is equals to. So here one equation is given, that is mod z minus 1 whole square plus mod z plus 1 whole square is equals to 4. Now I substitute that z is equal to x plus I y in this equation. X plus I y minus 1 whole square plus x plus I y plus 1 whole square is equals to 4. Now finding the modulus value, so this is square root of x minus 1 whole square plus y square, okay. Finding the modulus value whole square plus this is square root of real part whole square, x plus 1 whole square plus y square whole square is equals to 4. Now cut the squares and square roots. Now taking the expansions here, this is x square minus 2x plus 1 plus y square, and the second term is x square plus 2x plus 1 plus y square, okay. Now cut the minus 2x and plus 2x here. So this is equals to x square plus x square 2x square, y square plus y square 2y square, 1 plus 1 2 is equals to 4. Then 2x square plus 2y square is equals to 2. Then the value of the x square plus y square is equals to 1, and that is the second option. That's all. Now see the next problem. If z is equals to x plus iv is a complex number satisfying the condition, modulus of z plus I by 2 whole square is equals to modulus of z minus I by 2 whole square. Then what is the locus of the z? So here also first I substitute that z is equals to x plus I by in the given condition. So this is x plus I by plus I by 2 whole square is equals to x plus I by minus I by 2 whole square. Now finding the magnitude value, square root of real part whole square, x square plus y plus 1 by 2 whole square, imaginary part y plus 1 by 2 is equals to square root of x square plus y minus 1 by 2 whole square, okay. Now squaring on both sides, then we get x square plus y plus 1 by 2 whole square is equals to x square plus y minus 1 by 2 whole square. Now this is equals to y square plus 1 by 4 minus plus 2 into y into 1 by 2 is equals to y square plus 1 by 4 minus 2ab minus 2 into y into 1 by 2. That is y is equals to minus 5. That is 2y is equal to 0 means y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0 means this is nothing but x axis. So answer is equal to x axis, and that is the first option. In the argon plane all the complex next problem. In the argon plane all the complex numbers that satisfying the Cartesian, modulus of z minus 4i plus modulus of z plus 4i is equals to 10 lie on the so what is the locus of the z here? That is a given question. Already we know that if mod z minus z1 plus mod z minus z2 is equals to k represents an ellipse, if the condition is, if this equation represents an ellipse, if z1 z2 is less than k, okay. So here what is z1 value? Here we have and compare these two, we have that is equals to 4i, z1 is equals to 4i and z2 is equals to minus 4i. So this is equal to 0 comma 4 and this is equal to 0 comma minus 4. Now what is the z1 just distance between these two values? That is equals to 4 plus 4, distance between these two equals to 8, exponents equal. So just to take the simply the difference between the y coordinates, 4 minus minus 4, that is 8 less than 10. Clearly here from the given equation we have that k is equals to 10 and the value of the z1 z2 is equals to 8 means 8 less than 10. So 8 less than 10 means this is under the condition z1 z2 less than k, so that equation represents an ellipse. Okay, see the next question. If mod z plus z bar plus mod z minus z bar is equal to 2, then z lies up. So first I substitute the values here, z is equal to x plus iv and z bar is equal to x minus iv. Plus here also z is equals to x plus iv minus x plus iv, z bar is equal to x minus iv is equals to 2. So here imaginary part is cancelled, here real part is cancelled. Mod 2 x plus modulus of 2 iy is equals to 2. Now taking the 2 common from the entire equation here, modulus of x plus modulus of iy is equals to 2. That is mod x plus mod y is equals to square root of this value is nothing but mod y is equals to 1. So this equation represents the square. Mod x plus mod v is equal to 1 means that represents the square. Now see the next problem. If z is a complex number, then z square plus z bar square is equals to 2 represents. So first what is z value? We take that always z is equals to x plus iv, then the value of the z bar is equal to x minus iv. So given equation is z square plus z bar square is equals to 2, that is x plus I by whole square plus x minus I by whole square is equals to 2. Now taking the expansion, so this is x square plus I square y square plus I into 2xy plus x square plus I square y square minus I into 2xy is equals to 2. Okay, x square plus x square 2x square minus y square 2y square is equals to 2. Then x square minus y square is equals to 1. This is nothing but the rectangular hyperbola. X square minus y square is equal to k square. That equation represents the rectangular hyperbola. So the given equation is the hyperbola. Okay, so all the complex numbers level 2 questions are completed. Now in the next class I start the De Moivre's theorem. Okay.